And second example, that is CMC. CMC means complement carry. If carry equal to 1, and if we write CMC, then carry equal to 0. If carry equal to 0, if we write CMC, then carry equal to 1. So this is nothing but, in CMC no any operand specify, in STC no any operand specify. So we move to our second addressing mode, that is register addressing mode. In register addressing mode, source and destination both are register. So here you can write source and destination both are register. Gujarati માં શું લખવાનું? Source અને destination બંને કેવા હશે? Register હશે. Ready? So whatever data specify inside the B register that are transfer into A register. So you can write here B data transfer into A. If B contain 20H and if you want to specify MOV A comma B, then A equal to 20H. Same way, you can give lots of example, MOV A comma C, MOV A comma D, MOV A comma E, A, B, C, D, E, and H, L. Between these, you can specify any register as a source, any register as a destination. So this is nothing but register addressing mode. Now we move to our next addressing mode, that is immediate addressing mode. In immediate addressing mode, directly value that is specify. In register addressing mode, we specify as a source register. In immediate addressing mode, we specify as a source value. This is nothing but, you can say as a value or you can say as a data. We want to directly specify data. Here immediate I value, that is shortcut here, MVI, MVI A comma 20H. So after execution this instruction, if A contain whatever data, if we execute MVI A comma 20H, then ultimately A contain 20H. So in this way we can initialize any register. If you want to transfer L directly 20H, then you can write MVI L comma 20H. If you want to transfer 20H into H register, then you can directly specify MVI A comma MVI H comma 20H. Same way, if you want to transfer any value to D register, then you can write MVI D comma any value, means 20, 30, 40, 50, whatever value that we want to assign. So this is nothing but immediate addressing mode. Now we want to move our next addressing mode, that is direct addressing mode. In direct addressing mode, according to its name, we want to specify address. Suppose this is our address. Whatever data stored inside this address that are directly copied into A register. So data specified by address that are stored into A. For example, 20508 contain 88H, and if you want to execute LDA2050H, then our accumulator content 88, means data specified by address. Here address and this one, that is nothing but data. So address content 88H. So ultimately that data store into A. So accumulator content 88. So using LDA, you can transfer any memory location data into accumulator. So this is nothing but direct addressing mode. Now we move to our next addressing mode, that is indirect addressing mode. In indirect addressing mode, according to its name, we don't want to specify direct address. In direct addressing mode, we want to specify direct address. But in indirect addressing mode, according to its name, we don't want to specify direct address. So which memory location data that are transferred, that is specified by HL pair. Suppose H contain 20, L contain 50H, then 2050H, that becomes a memory location. So here M, that contain, you can write here, address specified by HL pair. M, that is nothing but address specified by HL pair. Gujarati mein lakhvanu ke H ane L thi banavela address. Upar na data, mano ke 88 che, and then if it execute MOV A comma M, then accumulator content 88H. So here we don't want to specify directly 2050H. But 2050H, that is indirectly stored into HL register. So ultimately HL becomes our address, HL pair that becomes our address, and address contain 88H. So this address data that are transferred into accumulator. So in this way we can differentiate direct and indirect. Indirect addressing mode, only one instruction, MOV A comma M, and second instruction, that is MOV M comma A. So here whatever data store inside the A register, if A contain 88H and M, that is nothing but address specified by HL pair. If H equal to 20, L equal to 50, then address becomes 2050H. So this accumulator data that are stored into this address, that is 2050H, contain now 88H. So in this way we can complete our addressing mode question. Thank you.